In the previous session, we have seen the divisibility rule of number 15. In this session, let's check out the divisibility rule of number 16. The divisibility rule of number 16 states that the number first has to be an even number for it to be divisible by 16. Also, if the last four digits is divisible by 16, then the whole number is divisible by 16. Okay, so let us take a large number and try to verify how this works out. Okay, we'll take a number, say 7, 8, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6. So the rule says that the number has to be even. In this case, it ends with the digit 6, so that rule is applicable. The next part is the last four digits has to be divisible by 16. So to check whether 7, 8, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6 is divisible by 16, I only need to check if 1, 4, 5, 6 is divisible by 16. So in order to check that, first let's write down the whole of the 16 table that we need, so it will be easier to perform all divisions. I'm putting from 16 twos are, so 16 ones are 16, so 16 twos are 32, 16 threes are 48, 16 fours are 64, 16 fives are 80, 16 sixes are 96, 16 sevens are 112, 16 eights are 128, 16 nines are 144, 16 tens are, we know it is 160, so I'm not putting it. Okay, now let us take 1, 4, 5, 6 and divide it by 16. So if I say 1, 4, 5, 6, I'm going to divide this by 16. So 16 nines are 144, that gets me a remainder 1. I bring down the 6, 16 ones are 16, this is no remainder. 1, 4, 5, 6 is divisible by 16. Therefore, 7, 8, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6 is also divisible by 16. That is what the rule says. Now, let us try to do a long division to see how much of difference or time and energy that you save by taking this simple rule. Okay, let's erase this. Now, we are going to take the 7, 8, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6 and divide it by 16. Just to check what is the difference, amount of difference in calculation. So 7, 8, 2, 1, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to try to divide this in 16. 78. So this is 16 fours are 64, right? Sorry, I scrapped the scroller. 16 fours are 64. So that gets me a remainder 14. I bring down the 2. Then I do a 16 eights are 128, again another 14 is coming down, I bring down the 1, so in this case again I do a 128, right, so this is getting me 13, then I bring down the 4, so in this case I do another 8, this is 128, so this gets me a 6, then 65. So this time I'm going to do 16 fours are 64. Let me move this away. So this is 16 fours are 64, remainder 1. Again I bring down the 6. This time it is 1. So it is 16, remainder is 0. Okay. So we saw in the long division method also how this number becomes divisible by 16, but if you see, compare the number of divisions, amount of divisions that we have done, then we see we are saving a lot of time. So this rule of divisibility of 16 will be especially helpful when you have very large digits. Now let us take another long digit and see whether this rule is able to help us eliminate it. Okay. So in this case, let's take a number which is actually not getting divisible by 16. So let's try, say 9, 8, 2, 3, 1, 5, 4. This is also an even number, so we need to do the division. Instead of doing it on the 7 digits, let's take up 3, 1, 5, 4. So 3, 1, 5, 4, let's divide it by 16. 16 ones are 16, so that's getting me 155. So it is 16 nines are 144, 11, 14. So this is 16 sevens are 112. You get a remainder 2. Okay, 3154 is not divisible by 16. Therefore, the whole number, that is 9823154, is not divisible by 16. Okay, so this helps us in eliminating the large numbers on which you can do the divisibility of 16. Now let us try a 3-digit number to see how to do the divisibility of 16. There is a small trick that you can try to do on 3-digit numbers so that it becomes easier to do the divisibility. For example, you have a number, say 464. This is a 3-digit number. Take the number in the hundredths place, multiply it by 4, then add it to the remaining number, and if the given number is divisible by 16, then the whole set of number, 3-digit number, is divisible by 16. This will be relatively easier to calculate rather than doing it for the 3-digit numbers. And also you only have to remember 5 2-digit numbers that are divisible by 16, right? 32, 48, 64, 80 and 96. All other numbers are 3-digit numbers. So now let us take this rule, 464. I need to multiply 4 by 4. So that fetches me as 16. I'm adding it to the 64. So this gives me 80, which is divisible by 16. Therefore, 464 is divisible by 16. Let us take another number, 732. In this case, I need to multiply 7 by 4. That is getting me 28. Now I need to add this 28 to 32, which means 8 plus 2 is 10. So I bring in a 1. 3 plus 2 is 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. 60. 60 is not divisible by 16. Therefore, 732 is also not divisible by 16. You can check this for any 3-digit number and this will easily work. So we'll take some of these 3-digit numbers that we have here. Say for example, 128. Okay, I need to multiply this 1 by 4, so that's getting me 4. 28 plus 4 is 32. 16 2s are 32, so 128 is divisible by 16. Now let's try 16 9s are, so that also fetches me a 144. I need to multiply this by 4, which gives me 4 again. 44 plus 4 is 48, 16 3s are 48, so 144 is also divisible by 16. This way, you can check out any number that is 3-digit number, whether it is divisible by 16 or not, by not doing the rules. There are other additional tricks that you can try to bypass the division, but then that becomes too many rules for the divisibility of 16, so it becomes much more complex. So with these three rules, we have actually reduced the possible numbers of divisions in a large scale, right? We have eliminated all the odd numbers, and only for even numbers we will check the divisibility. And for 3 digits, if it is 3 digits, then we are going to do it in this fashion, where we take the digits in the hundreds place, multiply it by 4, add it to the remaining numbers, and then if that number is divisible by 16, then the whole number is divisible by 16. So we checked it out for 3 digits this way. As far as 2 digits are concerned, we know there are only 5 numbers that are possibly divisible by 16, which is 32, 48, 64, 80 and 96. All other 2-digit numbers are not divisible by 16. So we have eliminated quite a lot of numbers there as well. Now for the 4 digits and above, you need to do this way. So if it is 4 digits, then we will divide and check it. If not, if it is digits which have more numbers than 4 digits, it is easier because we are reducing the amount of division that we are going to actually do. Okay, so 16 digits per se in calculation is one of the complex divisibility rules of all the rules that we have seen so far. Okay, with this we will end the session. In the next session, I'll look forward to seeing you for the divisibility rule of number 17. Please subscribe to my channel for more videos. I look forward to seeing you there. See you soon. Bye.